Next into the tank tonight is another well-established business that is helping today's kids become tomorrow's technological leaders.
Coming on the show today, what we're really trying to do is sort of accelerate our business.
I do present in front of people quite regularly. I don't usually have this anxiety just before I'm about to do that. Look, I hope they can see that we've dotted I's and crossed T's.
Good evening, Sharks. My name is Frank, and I'm the founder of Scope IT Education. This here is my partner and general manager of the business, Tracy. Today, we're offering an investment in our business for $632,000 for a 15% holding. Now, today's investment is not about getting a startup business off the ground. It's about helping us to continue to facilitate our growth, but maybe more importantly, to continue to solve problems for Australia's education system. It's a business that teaches kids computer science. The education system has brought this in to be mandatory over the next couple of years. They've realised that it isn't just an ancillary subject anymore. We provide a full solution for primary schools across Australia to help them facilitate their ICT education in their schools and to ensure that all their students have a literacy in digital technologies.
We're a franchise business, currently 19 franchisees and 4 internal operational territories across 5 states of Australia. We've designed the program to reach every Australian child, regardless of location or social background. Every child will need this for the workforce of the future.
So Frank and Tracy, you're looking for $632,000 for 15% of your company, valuing your business at a cool $4.21 million. Is that correct?
That's correct.
So what age range are we talking about?
Our program is K, kindergarten or prep, that first year of school, so around 5.
5.
Right through to year 8, although we are working with year 9 students now as well.
My daughter's grade 2. And I don't know whether it's necessary to teach her coding at grade 2, considering by the time she's in grade 5, whatever she learns in grade 2 will be obsolete.
As long as she's got those underlying skills, then she'll grow with the technology. It won't be useless to her, as well as that computational thinking and algorithmic thinking, because employees in the future are going to require their employees to be clever and creative using technology. And the younger we get them, the more they'll learn and absorb over time.
It's a good answer.
It is a good answer.
So the education department are going to make coding mandatory in schools?
Digital technology is mandatory,
okay,
and coding's one aspect
of
it.
So surely that's going to destroy your business model then?
No, funnily enough, it won't, because what we actually do is we facilitate the lessons to be able to be run, because many schools just simply don't have the teaching staff, the courseware, all the hardware.
We're already in 150 schools. And the level of technology that's in schools at the moment is not great.
Where and how are they going to get it into their budgets?
This business, really, it has a bit of a philanthropic aspect to it. It's got a social impact, which is every student should have access to these type of lessons. So we brought the price down as far as possible.
Each course is one 40-minute lesson for 10 weeks. That's
right.
What each course is, so one term long.
Yeah.
So $5 per student per week, or $50 for the term.
A young friend of mine does a program at school, and I don't know if it's your program. Are you in Scarborough?
Yes.
Yes, we are.
We are.
Well, she's had incredible outcomes. She adores it.
How old was she?
She's 12.
12.
Okay. And she does, she did 3D printing, she did app development or something, and she was doing gaming. So tell us about the team. How have you structured your team?
Well, in head office, we have 4 executives, and we're the ones who actually run the team. We have about 20 staff that help facilitate the operation around the country, and then we have those 19 franchisees.
So just to find your profit, please, Frank.
For this year, we expect to make around between $520,000 and $550,000. That's profit.
Net profit?
Correct.
That's pretty good.
Where are we going to be in 3 years' time?
In year 3, we're budgeted at current to make $5.4 million.
$5.4 million top line, what's popping out the bottom?
That's $5.4 million profit.
$5.4 million net profit before tax in year 3.
Yes.
So, Frank, we didn't run a franchise operation, we ran a franchise-like operation. So 230 pet stores, 160 veterinary hospitals around Australia. So we get used to getting performance from remote places. You do need some scaling up support. I bring absolutely nothing on the tech front, but I did do computer science in grade 11 back in whatever year I went to school.
1902.
Something like that. I'm going to make you an offer. $632,000 for 39% of your company.
Ow.
Yeah.
Frank Lucisano and Tracy Richardson have presented an excellent case for a $632,000 investment in Scope IT. Glen's keen, but his valuation of the business is only just over a third of the original ask.
Look, my offer, and throw it out there for you, on the basis of the numbers you've told us today, $632,000 for 39% of your company.
Ow.
Yeah. I think he's really trying to steal from you here, eh?
Come on, Steve.
Give it a break. Wait, one second. This is $632,000. Are you flippant with $632,000? Because if he is, you should take him as a partner because he doesn't care about your business.
Get on with it. Be a bit decisive.
Congratulations on getting 19 franchisees in 2 years. You know, the franchise sector is very, very difficult, so you're obviously doing something right. I suppose that where I struggle knowing the franchise sector and knowing a lot of franchisees out there, I don't believe that you'll be making $5.4 million in 3 years. I do hope you prove me wrong. I'm out.
Thank you anyway.
How many franchisees is that in 3 years then?
In the 3 years, well, that would actually be mostly internally run territories to reach that $5.4 million.
Right.
The capital we're asking for today will actually facilitate 14 more internal territories, and they're much more profitable than the franchise model.
You reckon if we drop in $632,000, 14 regions, doubling the size of the business with this investment? 19 to 14, pretty close.
But 14 very profitable regions because they're internally owned, as opposed to 19 ones that are externally owned.
Look, I think your space is clearly very appropriate. There's no debate about that. But you're only as good as your content. I think you're going to make money, but I think you've got a window of 5 to 7 years, and then you're going to be disrupted, I think, by different models. So I wish you luck, but I'm out.
Thank you.
Whenever I look at an investment, I also look at what value am I going to add. I think you're a very accomplished team. I think you're doing a great job. I think it's a very important piece of work you do. Keep going, keep growing. It's not an investment for me. I'm out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So I'll make you an offer. I'll $632,000, obviously. 30%.
Okay, two offers, one at 39%, one at 30%.
If you don't mind me asking you a question, then, what do you think, apart from the cash, could you actually bring to us?
Not much.
I've had a lot of exposure to coding over the years. I think it's integral to entrepreneurship, so I've got a bit of a love affair with it. I have a deep love affair with getting kids to be smarter and get engaged with tech.
Okay. Yep. So, Glen, are you going to counter that?
I don't think you need similar experience. I think you need someone who knows how to scale up a business and to get performance out of your franchisees from a remote headquarters. You guys are expert in doing this, but what I'm going to assist is the coaching and the support in rolling out a network across Australia and then working out how to get performance out of that network. I'll go to my lucky number 33. $632,000 for 33%.
So you have two offers on the table.
So 33% from Glen, 30% from Steve.
What would you like to do?
Okay, we really appreciate your offer and we think it's a really enticing thing to take, but unfortunately that position of equity would be a little bit too much for us to give away at this point in time. Steve, to your offer, we only actually have authority from our other two shareholders to let a position go of up to 25%. So we're wondering if there is something that can be done. This would actually make you also the largest shareholder.
Yeah, well, wouldn't it?
And it'd be the first time that we've actually broken where we don't have equal shares from the business. So it is a big step for us to let something like this go.
Mm-hmm. Yep, let's do it.
Oh, cheers. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, my God. Thank you so much.
Looking forward to it.
Congratulations. Well done.
Thank you so much. I can't believe it.
Good job.
Well done.
You too.
That was so exciting. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe that just happened.
Have we seen a general manager that capable of walking into this business?
It's a scale-up business, full management team ready to rock and roll it out across Australia. It's a good deal.